Καλημέρα σας φίλες και φίλοι και καλώς ήρθατε στο Kalimera USA. Θέλουμε να αφοσιωθείτε στη σημερινή μας εκπομπή γιατί έχει πολλά ωραία θέματα υγείας. Πώς θα χάσουμε βάρος, θα συζητήσουμε πώς να βάλουμε βάρος, θέματα για διατροφή και πάρα πολλά ωραία άλλα θέματα που βοηθάει να κάνουμε την ζωή μας καλύτερη. Ladies and gentlemen, good morning and welcome to Kalimera USA. We have a wonderful show for you today. It's about weight loss, weight gain, various behavioral problems that might lead to certain eating disorders. We're going to learn how to exercise. We're going to discuss wonderful ways to make our nutritional habits better by alternating to more natural foods. And we have a wonderful panel here with us. We have Xenia Soteriou, who is a professor of behavioral sciences and a counselor. We have George Giannopoulos, who is a professor of exercise physiology. And we have Anne Carpenter, who is a holistic health counselor, who's going to tell us everything that we need to know about food and what we should be eating and what we should not be eating. Welcome to our show, guys. Thank you for being here with us.
Thanks for having us.
This is a topic that needs to be discussed on a daily basis. And I'd love to start with weight loss and, you know, weight gain. And I believe that everything is psychological. And I think Xenia is perfect to help us understand a little bit more about what happens with people who suffer from obesity and a lot of weight gain.
I think you touched on the right thing, saying it's psychological in nature, and I think it's a very complex issue. Weight loss seems to kind of touch on so many aspects of our lives, so many aspects of our upbringing, our society, the culture, our job, our own expectations of ourselves, our levels of confidence, our levels of assertiveness play into how we use food to cope. So typically someone who is overweight or eats more than they kind of want to, so that typically someone would eat when they're not hungry, so they'll feel full but still continue to eat, and that's what we call emotional eating. And that typically happens because there are other issues in our life which are there and we're trying to cope. So food is used actually as a coping mechanism. Some of those things can be just simply the messages we receive as children. They can be mixed. You know, one day you're allowed to eat something and the next day, you know, it's bad for you, don't eat it, so now you're very confused. Then society is bombarding us with so many messages about weight loss. You know, you have the paleo diet, you have the South Beach diet, you just don't know where
it's
to
start.
It's
very confusing.
It's very confusing.
Yeah. And it's going to elaborate on that.
Exactly. And I do feel that nutrition is a very big part. So yes, we have a psychological factor, but what we eat is also a huge factor on
absolutely. And behavior is exactly what is learned. And we have been raised in society here in the United States, not only the United States, the world considers being thin being beautiful. And the United States is very, very, you know, pro thin and exercise and a little bit to the extreme sometimes. Right. I think we need to be more pro health instead of pro thin. And everyone's body weight should be according to their body size and body mass indexes, as George is going to explain to us, is different for every body type. Behavior is a very big part of it, but it's also genetic. We have hormonal problems and biological. George, would you like to let us know what some of the factors are for people who suffer from obesity, which obesity is considered, by the way, a disease. And well, what plays the biggest roles in obesity?
Well, first of all is how much you eat. Second is sometimes is genetic. Many people will say that they don't eat a lot, that they don't consume a lot of food. That might not be the case all the time, but there is some an intrinsic set point that the body stores more calories that it burns. Now, through exercise, and very well point from Xenia, that psychological modification might need to take place in order to go into an exercise program, burn the calories that you consume extra, maybe modify a little bit your eating habits in order to have the result. But we have to understand that there is no model out there. We have to understand that we need to be good and feel good about ourselves the way that we are, as we are meant to be. We can construct a new body, either by exercise or by nutrition, and it cannot happen alone. It will take both nutrition, good nutrition, and exercise.
And behavioral and modification.
Yes, yes, very well pointed.
And education, because people do need to become more educated about what is a calorie, how do calories get stored, how much to exercise, what not, you know, what type of exercises are not good, because a lot of people are doing exercises that are not going to help them get to their goals. They're learning and doing the wrong kinds of exercises.
Of course. Or doing the same thing over and over again.
And then food allergies and foods that are affecting and causing inflammation that Anne's going to tell us about. But going back to Xenia real quick, I think that we need to tell our viewers that the first part about a weight loss program is to mentally be ready for it and not be ready for it because we're being pushed by our spouse or by our or by society. You need to make that decision that I want to lose weight. Mm-hmm. I want to change my life. I want to zip off the fat.
Right. Yes, you have to definitely be ready. You also have to choose a time in your life where it's not when there's no chaos, when things are not falling apart, you know, when you're at your weakest and you need your coping strategies to be able to move forward, to get through the difficult times. So it's really about identifying times, for example, if you're exercising, times in the day which you're not distracted. But aside from that, because I know you guys are going to talk more about that, but aside from that, you have to kind of know, okay, is this the right time for me? And then you have to also personally know, what am I confident at? What weight am I confident at? What am I going to be happy with? Because if you are keep on moving the goalposts, so if you say I'm going to lose 10 pounds, but then you get there, but then you say actually no, I'm going to lose 20 pounds, and then you lose 12, but then you move it to 25, you're constantly changing that. And what's happening is you're demotivating yourself. You're
pressure.
You're putting additional pressure. And then, like you said, Yanna, who am I doing this for? Am I doing it for me or am I doing it for someone else's expectations? And when you do it for you, your success is going to be much greater than when you're trying to meet someone else's expectations. So it has to come from you. And then you have to identify, what are my trigger points? So what leads me to eating? And a good way of kind of assessing that is to actually have a food diary, noting the time you eat, what you've eaten, and was there a situation that occurred prior to eating? So for example, did you have a conversation with your spouse that wasn't very good, or did you have a trouble at work, or what were some of the triggers? Also, if you have a food diary, by the end of the week, by filling it in for a week, you're able to understand what points of the day are my least are my weakest points. Sometimes the evenings, right after we kind of are able to relax, we tend to kind of consume huge amounts of food because that's a way of relaxing, that's a way of cutting off the rest of the day, what has happened in the day. So it is a very useful way to start. You know, what are my trigger points? What am I eating to lead to my lack of success in weight loss?
What are the most common trigger points that lead to the bingings or getting off track?
I personally think anxiety, depression, and low self-esteem are major triggers. And sometimes we can have what we call mask depression, where it can be either manifested as a bodily symptom. Sometimes you people kind of have aches, but really it's psychological. Or sometimes you just have this low mood, low energy. You're kind of not that you're depressed or suicidal, but you're not happy. Or you have anxiety. You have like anxiety that you're not aware of. And I think anxiety can lead to a lot of eating because you're trying to soothe yourself. You're trying to kind of minimize anxiety.
Well, let's give our viewers some idea about some signs of depression and different types of depression and signs of anxiety that you might be experiencing, and when is it a good time to see a professional?
Sure, some of the signs of depression are, if we talk about severe depression, are obviously a lack of interest in going out or doing normal activities. Lack of interest in self-care. So people who are extremely depressed don't actually bathe, don't actually look after themselves, don't brush their hair. They're really not kept very well. And then typically in depression, if it's a typical depression, you have decreased appetite and decreased sleep. And we know that sleep interferes with weight. But then you can have atypical depression where you have increased need to sleep and you have increased appetite, and that can lead to weight gain. So those are some of the kind of symptoms of depression, including suicidal ideation, a lack of interest in talking, conversing with people, kind of feeling that there's nothing in my life to keep me going. Why am I here? I don't want to be here anymore. Those are kind of the kind of feelings and things that people say. Then you have anxiety, and you have different forms of anxiety. You can have panic attacks, you can have generalized anxiety, and a lot of people actually suffer from generalized anxiety.
Why don't we give them some samples or some ideas, give them a description of what anxiety feels like.
Right, anxiety is when you constantly feel that something is going to go wrong. You constantly feel that something is going to fall apart, something bad's going to happen to you or someone else. And you, when you have generalized anxiety, you're constantly worrying about everything and anything in your life, from getting to work on time, to making dinner, to getting to the gym, and you have this kind of edge, you're always on edge, a feeling of jitters and edge. And that can kind of lead to a lot of health problems, but inability to cope with things, and then you look for other coping mechanisms, maybe food or something to help with that.
So these are a lot of signs of, these are a lot of trigger, behavioral triggers that lead to weight gain and weight loss.
Right, exactly, absolutely.
And what do you suggest to our viewers when they, if any of them have, they feel that they might be suffering from some of the examples that you just mentioned?
I think it's very important to talk to your doctor and just tell them how you're feeling, and understand that sometimes we do experience physiological symptoms, but the root is psychological, and if we can penetrate the psychological aspect, then you start to feel better both physically and mentally. So don't kind of think that everything is medical. There is a lot of psychological. Obviously, don't ignore medical, because it's very important. Because sometimes we tend to, obviously, as a counselor, everything is psychological, you know? It's not. There are medical conditions, and depression and anxiety are medical as well.
And clinical depression is a different level of depression.
Exactly.
And things are also chemical imbalances, that things that you cannot avoid,
absolutely,
that you're born with. So these are things that you need to look out for, guys. These are, you know, good tips from Xenia. And George, give us some idea of exercise programs that people can do to avoid depression, and not avoid, to help depression and anxiety, because depression has hormonal imbalances that exercise can fight.
I don't know the way that depression has to do with exercise. However, a lot of research out there shows that it helps. The way I interpret it in my terms, I say that whenever someone gets off his chair and starts walking and starts exercising and going out, be a little bit outgoing and enjoy the nature, especially this period of time. Besides the fact that he's going to be losing calories, controlling his weight, think about it the other way. He's away from the food, so he's doing something for himself, making himself feel better. He might look better in the overall exercise regimen, and some expressions will be based on the result. Okay, he will see that he's burning more calories, he's exercising more, he's losing weight, he's closer to his realistic goal. Because certain people, they have to be careful about the goals that they are setting for themselves. Either that is exercise or nutrition.
Keep it real, people. Keep it real. And exercise does fight depression, because it releases the endorphins, of which are the hormones that make you feel happy.
Definitely. It's the athlete's high, as we say. And remember, there are many advertisements out there that they say, if you keep moving and you're doing exercise, you will not stop.
Yeah.
Okay, so that is also an incentive to know.
Exactly. And Anne, tell us some foods that people can eat that would help them feel better to fight depression and anxiety.
Well, I think first of all, probably just getting a balanced diet all around, not eating processed foods, eating whole foods, and getting your protein and your vegetables. But most of all, I think vegetables are very important, but trying to balance it out and not just focusing on, I just want to eat meat and that makes me feel good. You really need to get all your vitamins from a whole source.
George, give us some exercise tips for weight loss.
Long-term exercise, and not to think as a time period. It has to be a change of life. You need to be active in your life. I don't think there is anybody in this science or non-science environment that will disagree with that. We have to make it a way of life. We had a very interesting talk in the back room before, and I will share some of this information. There are 1,440 minutes in each day. We can give 30 to 40 minutes for our health. And I believe that exercise does help a lot of these conditions we talked about before. So going through the exercise regimen doesn't have to be intense, doesn't have to be difficult, because there are going to be some injuries involved. We don't need to go to that extreme. As long as we keep it going 30 minutes constant, maybe 20. Maybe someone who doesn't have the time, and that is a very common excuse. Everybody has the time. We make time if we want to. So we can break it down into 10-minute exercise bouts. So we need to keep going.
Just keep moving, guys. We want you to start exercising. And exercise consists of many different forms. So aerobic exercise is what we need to burn that stored fat.
And let's not forget that there are health benefits and there are skill benefits, athletic benefits. Mm-hmm. So depending on what every person wants to do, if he wants to become a better athlete, he needs to talk into an exercise physiologist, someone who does this, personal trainer, as we call them. All right, so they will help him in that way. However, the health benefits are for everybody. Okay, maybe we get to decrease a little bit the dosages of the medications that we already take. That is a health benefit. It will not get me to the doctor if I have high blood pressure, because we know exercise decreases high blood pressure. Now, cholesterol gets decreased. Many risk factors that lead us to the doctor get decreased by just doing a simple 20-minute walk, 30-minute jog if you wish. However, we need to pay some attention to people over 45 to go have a stress test before they start a vigorous, moderate to vigorous exercise program.
So what we want you to do is see a behavioral specialist, a counselor that can help you if you feel like you're having some sort of stress, anxiety, you might have some signs of depression that have led to your weight gain. It's very important that we have that behavioral modification. Then we want you to learn about exercise, inform yourselves, get up and get going, whether it be joining a gym or reading books on how to exercise, but we want you to begin movement. And my exercise book in Greece that I wrote is movement. That's what I wrote, kinesi. We want you to move. Get those calories going. We're too sedentary. Life has caused us to sit behind desks or in front of a television set. It is so horrible for people. They're gaining weight just by their lifestyle. Back in the day, nobody had cars. Everybody used to walk. There were more manual labor jobs. Now everyone is behind. Technology has caused a lot of different health, unfortunately.
Sedentary
lifestyles. It's becoming a sedentary lifestyle. So that's what we're here to tell you is we want you to begin your exercise program. At least you should be exercising 2 to 5 times a week for a minimum of 15 to an hour and a half, 90-minute exercise program that consists of strength training, cardiovascular training, and stretching. These are all wonderful components. Aspects. They're
components, very important components that it comes to the form of breaking down the whole sequence of events that take place in an exercise program. However, I need to stress this. It's not only exercise that does that. Nutrition, whatever you eat, it's very important.
Goes hand in hand. Nutrition and weight loss goes hand in hand. And we have a wonderful example today with us, one of our segment producers and one of our panel on our chat at our show is Irini Lignos, who is going to tell us how she lost weight. She's going to tell us her story. We're going to just take a quick commercial break, and then we're going to jump into some exercise tips and come right back to our panel. Stay with us.
Τώρα η ομορφιά δεν απαιτεί θυσίες. Στο The Face & Body Shop θα αποκτήσετε την ομορφιά και τη λάμψη που αξίζετε. Χρησιμοποιούμε μόνο βιολογικά προϊόντα στις βαφές μαλλιών, την αποτρίχωση και τον καθαρισμό προσώπου. Μοναδικά αποτελέσματα στη θεραπεία κυταρίτιδας και λέιζερ. The Face & Body Shop. Εμπιστευτείτε μας σήμερα κιόλας. Διεύθυνση 4021 23 Avenue, Αστόρια, και τηλέφωνο 718-204-9390. Αναλαμβάνουμε την περιποίηση για τις μικρές πριγκίπισσες στα παιδικά πάρτι.
Before you start an exercise program, make sure that you check with your doctor in order to find out what exercises are right for you. And remember, during your exercise program, take breaks, drink some water in order for you to stay hydrated. As you exercise, make sure your shoes are well-fitting, and in good condition. When you start a strength exercise program, make sure that you start with a lightweight, and as you become stronger, progress into a heavier weight. There is no magic formula for you to increase muscle mass. The only safe and sure way to increase your muscle mass is through resistance training.
Λοιπόν, George, great exercise tips. And now we have with us Irene Lignos. Irene Lignos is going to tell us her story. How many pounds did you lose, Irene?
I think it's 165 total.
165 pounds. She is an example to everyone. She's got a wonderful story. She was very determined. And she's going to tell us about it. So tell us exactly what weight you started with, Irene.
I weighed in the last time at 299, actually.
So tell us why you had gained so much weight. Give us the backstory and tell us what happened to your behavioral modification techniques to get to where you are today.
Well, you know, my entire teenager to adulthood, I was kind of yo-yoing back and forth between 190 and 220, 190 and 220. And then finally, when I went to go to Paris to learn how to be a chef, I kind of ate every single thing in Paris. No remorse, every cheese, every butter on a baguette, everything.
And were you aware that you were gaining weight? Did you care, or you were just...
I was aware, but I almost thought it'd be easy to come off. I would just probably do one of the fad diets I had done in the past, and it would be simple.
All those fad diets, all those lies, all those lies.
They don't
believe those diets.
They definitely do not work, and I found myself coming home to New York, and my father actually passed me at the airport when he was picking me up because he didn't recognize me at all.
Wow.
And
was that your wake-up call?
It was about a month after that it was really my wake-up call, when I found myself going out to dinner and ordering salads with everyone, and then, you know, going home and ordering in Ben and Jerry's and Cheetos and, you know, anything that I was in the mood for.
So were you a closet eater?
Definitely, 100% a closet eater. And I still find myself, even 10 years later, with certain habits where I'll face the wall while I'll eat, or I'll, you know, I tend to gravitate towards that. I eat on my feet.
Did you?
It's a little strange, but I definitely am aware of it, so I try not to.
Did you suffer from any eating disorders such as bulimia?
No, I've never ever been bulimic, and I've never been able to. I tried. I mean, but I'm very happy that I never was. Yes.
Well, thank God you weren't. That's
yes,
good.
It's a terrible, terrible
thing.
Did
you see a therapist?
I did throughout growing up. Even I went to trainers, I went to all different courses, I went to fat camp, weight loss camp, I did everything. My parents were extremely supportive about me losing weight. They wanted me to do anything and everything for it. I went to nutritionists at NYU, I did everything.
What was going on, and why you ended up using extreme measures to get that weight off, which we're going to discuss. It's very, very extreme measure. A lot of people don't even recommend it at all, ever.
I probably am one of them.
Yes, you are. That's why we're talking to you today, because this is an extreme measure she had.
Yes, so I, after a long time of trying and not losing.
What was it that wasn't helping you lose?
I would be discouraged when the weight didn't come off so quickly, so I didn't have the patience. So I would go on a diet for a month or two, and because I wasn't a stick a month later, I'd be like, oh, what's the point? Oh, there's no, you know.
Let's ask Xenia to get involved in this conversation. Xenia,
sure.
Go ahead, feel free.
I mean, you touched on a very important point about instant gratification. I think our society is designed to kind of give us success right away, and that's why you see all these commercials about weight loss pills and this fat diet and this, lose 10 pounds and, you know, a day. Seriously, it is really difficult, and when we start dieting, we have this expectation, and like you said, as soon as we start dieting and it's not happening quick enough, we get demotivated, and what happens, we resort to even more emotional eating. And I know you weren't purging.
No, I wasn't purging at all, and I still cannot, even if I feel sick, actually,
right,
funny
right.
enough. But I definitely would go on these crazy cabbage soup diet, you know, not eat anything, lemon water. I remember I used to be obsessed, even at a big, big weight, with these anorexia websites. And I would envy them and be like, how do they do this? And then
anorexia is a very,
it's very sad.
Another sad and
but you almost I
almost
think
death is the result of anorexia, because the heart is the biggest muscle in the body, and when you do not eat, your body needs the protein, and your body ends up eating your body, which is your muscle. And most women, if not all of them, suffer from cardiac arrest. The heart just has heart failure.
Well, it's very sad. I'm being just honest that, you know, as a big girl, you look at these thin girls and you think everything will be solved if you're thin, or everything will be solved if you can wear that outfit.
Everything will be solved if you're mentally okay and happy. It's all about happiness and
Absolutely.
Being okay with yourself. But I'd like you to tell our audience what extreme measure you took to get to where you are.
So I finally, you know, a friend of mine suggested it, and I said, no way, my Greek father, he's gonna say the only thing you should staple is your mouth, you know?
So tell the audience what happened. What decision did you make?
I did the gastric bypass surgery, which is the complete, it's called Roux-en-Y, the procedure I did. Which is a very extreme procedure. They not only make a small pouch with your stomach, but they also bypass one of the most important parts of your intestine, which is the duodenum, which is where you absorb not only fat and calories, but also nutrients and, you know, healthy things that your body needs. So your body goes into, I guess, a mode of you can't eat too much. You reach a satiation level faster. Your brain sees that you are full faster. And then you don't also absorb all of it. So it was a very interesting journey having that. And in the beginning, I mean, just in the hospital, I think I lost 20 pounds of water weight. And then
what did you do to keep the weight off, and how many years did it take you to get to this weight?
It took me 4 years to really lose all the weight, and it's because I did it in a healthy way. Because I couldn't eat so much, I made sure I set timers. I would eat every 2 hours, protein shakes, make sure I was getting in the amount of protein, vegetables, everything green.
Did you change your lifestyle and your nutritional habits?
You have to. You have no option not to. I can no longer eat ice cream. It's a rare occasion.
So the example that we would like for you all to take home with you today in your minds is that she did take an extreme measure of weight loss, but she has modified and changed her lifestyle. That's why she's keeping the weight off, because there are many examples of gastro bypass that they gain the weight back. So unless, we're getting back to this, we want you to be happy with yourself. We want you to go see a counselor. We need you to get educated on the information of how to exercise, what exercise program can help you get to the goal that you need. And you need to change the way you eat. And we're gonna pass on now to our good friend here, Anne Carpenter, and she's gonna talk to us a little bit about food and the difference of processed food with all natural food.
Well, first of all, with changing your habits, it's not something that you can do immediately. It's, you know, some people look at it like they can hit it with a giant fairy stick and everything will poof change. Like you were saying, you know, going through and wanting immediate gratification, wanting to do this soup diet and being a stick in a week. It doesn't happen like that. You'll never be able to keep that up. You have to start with small things. And initially, maybe just make one change in your diet. Start incorporating salads before every meal for a month and see how that works for you. Don't make big changes. Make it small at first.
Just like Xenia was saying earlier, and George, we need to do small changes so we don't surprise ourselves and feel the stress. And mentally, we can't have such a big change in our
lives. We have to understand that you can't fool your body. Mm-hmm. Your body's very smart. You try to shake it, it will respond. And you have to cope with it. So you don't need, as you said, do certain sudden changes in your body. You have to go very mellow with your body. And whoever says that you lose or you gain weight easily is lying.
That's true.
You don't. okay? You just
That's a complete
don't.
Lie. And we want everyone to know that.
I can say it now.
Things take time. And there are a lot of extreme measures. That's what we're saying. We want you to be careful of all these fad diets. But going back to food for a second, one of the fads of today is juicing, which I love. I am a big, big fan of juicing and liquid dieting. I love it. I just think that, you know,
juicing is fantastic.
It's good to get away from, yes.
Yeah, juicing is absolutely fantastic. Especially with the green juices. But I think if anybody's going to start juicing, maybe they want to start with carrot juice. Carrot juice can do amazing things. Carrot apple juice has done amazing things for my eyesight. I was going to start wearing glasses, and I started juicing regularly, carrot juice alone, every day. You know, more than once a day, I'd have several carrot juices during the day, and I never needed the glasses. And
that's amazing.
Juicing is just an incredible thing. It's just a great way.
Nature. I think that nature is an incredible thing, and we have gone away from nature, and God has provided to us with everything on this earth, and
yes.
we are turning to things that are not of nature. And I think Hippocrates, we are the example as Hellenes. We want to preserve these philosophies and these wonderful herbal remedies that our ancient forefathers have brought to us. And Hippocrates was healing people with herbs and the earth. So we need to turn back to that, because when you don't feel well, when you're stressed out, when you're gaining weight, it's because you're getting away from a natural lifestyle. And if you want to fight depression, you want to fight anxiety, you want to, you know, have a remedy for eyesight or liver cleansing
or
depression, immune system, start looking for your source of health in food from nature, not processed food. Juice, guys. We want you to start juicing and eating vegetables and eating a lot of stuff that's not processed. Gluten-free diet, tell me about the gluten.
Okay, some people have celiac, which is, they don't have the enzyme to actually break down the gluten, which is in the wheat and the protein. And then that can pose really serious medical difficulties for people. Then there's people that have intolerances to wheat, okay, which is, it can form in the same manner. You can get in a fog from eating wheat. You can get very sick from it. It's not a good thing.
A lot of people are, and a lot of children with autism and behavioral disorders, they're going on gluten-free diets. The therapist, correct, Xenia?
There's obviously different trends that occur, but yes, one school of thought is that maybe diet has a very big part to play in disorders and childhood disorders, behavioral problems in general.
And obesity is another disorder that we're facing. It's a disease amongst the new generation.
Yes, absolutely. We were just talking in the back room before we started the show that we see parents exposing kids to processed food at a very young age.
And force feeding. This Greek thing of five, and then we eat. This has to stop.
When you're chasing the children around the kitchen and then the garden.
I understand if your child doesn't eat and they're very thin, but force feeding a child, nature again provides, and God provided an instinct of I'm hungry. So allow your child to say to you, hey, I'm hungry.
Right.
You know, that there's not, you don't want to eat right now? Let me know when you're hungry. I'm a thesna fast.
It's not confused that the feeding is a need. It's not either to gratify someone and if you do this, I'm going to give you the cupcake. If you do this,
stop
I'm going to give you
using food as a reward.
Exactly.
And a punishment. Yes. And punishment.
Yeah,
punishment. Food is part of our life. It's not punishment. It's not a reward. We really have to help our children by avoiding these type of behavioral correlations to reward and punishment. And it's not only what we eat and how we exercise, it's also about how we maintain our skin and our body as well externally. And we're gonna go to the Face and Body Shop and learn about a couple of their services.
Hair on 14th, a full service salon that has a professional staff committed to providing a sophisticated, warm environment. Our expert stylists use the best products available in the beauty industry today. Come experience our superior techniques in highlights, color, cutting, styling, and more. Our Eurolaser Clinic has certified laser specialists that remove unwanted hair utilizing the Zimmer cooling method. JD Opticians, luxury eyewear that keeps your budget in sight. Premier European designers, Chanel, Bulgari, Tiffany, Oliver Peoples, Versace, and more. Personal service prescription eyewear, why you wait? We speak Greek, milame ellinika. Trust your eyes to the specialist, JD Opticians, for all your optical needs. 15255 10th Avenue, Whitestone, New York, 718-747-2470.
Astoria has everything you need, and we found a diamond in the rough, a store that's been here since 1991 that caters to everything you need to be beautiful. Hair, nails, face, body. The Face and Body Shop has got it all, right off 23rd Avenue here in Astoria. Let's go become beautiful. We are at the Face and Body Shop in Astoria with our famous skincare specialist and owner, Evie Konaris. Evie, you have a wonderful story. Thank you for having us.
Thank you. My pleasure.
So she is a Cypriot Brit, born and raised in London from Cyprus. Evie started out as a skincare specialist in London. That's where she studied.
Correct.
And then decided one day she got up and said, I'm moving to the United States.
That's exactly what happened.
So tell us your story.
I had just got married in London and decided, I visited New York actually, fell in love with it and decided one morning, well, I'm moving to New York. And that's exactly what I did. I started in 91 and it was actually a third of what it is now. It was very small, started working by myself, gradually hired a second esthetician and then grew into 3 hours. And as we grew over the years, added more services.
What type of services do you offer?
Right now we're full service. Spa, from facials to skincare, all aspects of skincare, body care, weight loss, inch loss, I should say, massages, nail treatments, hair. It's a completely different level. As estheticians, there's only one level we can get to. It has changed a lot over the years. From when I first started, what we were able to do was very minimal. It has expanded a lot simply because of the formation of products, mm-hmm. I'm going to say, because what's available now to us as professionals and to the in the retail industry, we can do a lot more as far as treating the skin or with inch loss or with the hair or with anything. If you go into a medical spa, it's a different profession.
Mm-hmm. Well, let me ask you the most important question. What can we do to look younger? I want to know what the secrets are without having to go, because a lot of people are very anti, you know, surgery. And I am one of these people. I don't believe in, I'm not a fan of plastic surgery. Mm-hmm. What can we do to maintain and keep our skin youthful?
I'm going to say the most important thing you can do is stay out of the sun. Or if you're in the sun,
I don't like that.
Sunblock.
We do not like really this answer, especially the Greeks. We like to be in the sun.
I know. You have to protect your skin. That's going to prevent anything.
Protecting the skin.
Okay.
What is the SPF level? I mean, there's so many different myths about, you need to wear 90. Does 90 work or is 30 just the top?
Yeah. Anything between 30 and 50 is going to do the job.
And 50 is complete blockout?
It'll block out most of it. It's not complete, it'll block out most of it.
You can get a tan
with
50?
You want something, you can still, yeah.
Wow.
You can.
What hours should we be avoiding going into the sun?
Of course, middle of the day, noon.
She's ruining the whole thing for me.
That's when you go inside, you relax.
You go inside and relax. You come to the spa and you get a facial.
Exactly.
And what's in fashion now, we hear, is shellac nail polish. And tell me a little bit more about that. Does that last longer? Do your nails chip? What is it about?
It does. It actually, it's regular polish to look at, but it's actually, it's dried under UV light. And the layering and the product that you use, you can keep the polish on for about 10 days.
Oh.
It doesn't chip off as easily as regular polish.
Skincare line, I notice that you have a lot of organic products.
We do. Our main line is actually the Eminence line from Hungary. It is purely organic.
A lot of celebrities are using it. I see Madonna's using it.
Yeah.
And what is the difference of organic and what ingredients don't exist that are better for your skin?
There are no perfumes, no synthetics. Even the organic ingredients they use are not GMO. They're not genetically modified. It's very pure.
Even
purer than what we eat here.
Amazing.
Most of the products, yeah.
And as a skincare specialist, tell me a little bit about what is the exact procedure at night we use an eye makeup remover?
Begin with cleansing.
Cleansing first.
Cleansing. So you got eye makeup remover, facial,
eye makeup first,
cleanser.
Then cleanser.
Correct. Toner.
Toner.
Toner's imperative, very important.
Is it really?
People skip it, but...
I skip it.
Most people skip it. They feel like it's an extra step that you can avoid.
What does it do exactly?
Toner will restore the pH of the skin after you've used the cleanser. We don't realize it, but the water we use here has a big effect on our skin. I'm sure you've had experiences where people have moved from another country, let's say, and suddenly I'm getting acne. I don't know why. Change of everything affects it. Obviously, the environment, the stress, whatever, but the water also plays a big deal.
Tell me a little bit about hyperpigmentation, scarring, and what else we can do with the facial to get rid of wrinkles, scarring, or hyperpigmentation.
Okay, as estheticians, we can... every facial we do is customized. So if you come in with any of those products, then our facial is going to be geared to treating whatever your needs are. Mm-hmm. So there are different peels we can use, there are different machines we can use in the facial. So it's not... A typical facial isn't going to take care of everything. Yeah, we try and focus on a particular product, a problem, try and help you with that. And then, of course, there's the relaxation part of the facial as well. What we have today, and actually I'm really excited about this, is we do cavitation with radio frequency.
Ah, so that radio frequency can help you loosen up the fat, get rid of it? What is
exactly.
it do? Because I'm going in right now.
That's exactly what it does. It actually causes the fat cells to implode. It's like you're shaking the fat cells, they implode, and then the body will eliminate the liquefied fat from the cells.
How does the body eliminate that fat?
It's eliminated through natural processes, through the kidneys, through your lymph drainage, through...
Okay, I am going to try this today.
And you actually see a difference with your first treatment. It is incredible. We're having amazing results.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
So how many... Yeah. Okay, so let's talk about the inches. Every time you do a treatment, how many inches do you lose?
It depends on the person. It depends on the area.
So let's say they want to lose 5 pounds. How many treatments do they need?
It's not pounds. It's fat. You're losing inches. We will measure you before your treatment.
Okay.
We will do the treatment. We will measure you after the treatment. And you can see it yourself.
But now I also want to mention here to our viewers that it's not only inch loss, it's also, how about skin tightening?
And tightening. Well, that's why you do the radio frequency.
Okay.
Cavitation, inch loss, radio frequency will tighten.
So this is good for people who want to tighten their skin. There's a lot of people who have lost weight that want to tighten their skin. There's people who want to lose weight. This will help them. But now let's remember that even if you do these treatments, we have to watch our diet.
Absolutely.
And we have to exercise so we can keep them off. It's not just as easy as, I know you would love that, everybody could just come to me.
Every week.
But the truth is that in order to maintain
your body,
It's a combination of it all.
It's great. There are a lot of people
secret Nestoria. We just discovered it and we're bringing it to you right here on New Greek Television, Kalimera USA.
Ο Dr. Peter Patetsios είναι Board Certified Γενικός Ενδοκιοχειρουργός και συνεργάζεται με το St. Francis και το North Shore University Hospital. Το πλήρες εξοπλισμένο μας ιατρείο προσφέρει όλες τις θεραπείες εγγυακών παθήσεων, διαγνωστικούς υπερήχους όλων των αρτηριακών και φλεβικών ασθενειών, θεραπεία της φλεβίτιδας με λέιζερ και σκληροθέραπη με εξαιρετικά αποτελέσματα και επεμβάσεις που προσφέρονται στο άνετο περιβάλλον μας. Ο Dr. Πατέτσιος και το προσωπικό μιλούν ελληνικά. Για ραντεβού επικοινωνήστε στο 516-570-6818.
Είμαι πολύ επερήφανος που προσφέρω τις υπηρεσίες μου στους ανθρώπους που υποφέρουν. Κάνω το καλύτερο, εύχομαι υγεία σε όλους.
Το United Brothers Fruit Market, γωνία 30 Avenue και 33ος δρόμος στην Αστόρια, έχει όλα τα εποχιακά και πεφτικά, τόσο φρέσκα και λαχταριστά, σαν να βγήκαν από τον κήπο σας. Ανοιχτό 24 ώρες καθημερινά σε 4.000 τετραγωνικά, προσφέρει μεγάλη ποικιλία από φρέσκα φρούτα και λαχανικά στις καλύτερες τιμές. Και τώρα, αποκλειστικά για το United Brothers Fruit Market, τοπικές φάρμες στο Long Island και Upstate New York θα παράγουν για μας εποχιακά φρούτα και λαχανικά όπως ραδίκια, βλήτα, σέσκουλα, ντομάτες, φασολάκια, αγκινάρες, σκουπιά και όλα τα φρέσκα μυρωδικά. Ροδάκινα με γεύση Ελλάδων και 11 ποικιλίες μήλων στο Apple House μας. Στο κατάστημά μας συνεχίζουμε να προσφέρουμε άριστη εξυπηρέτηση, καθαριότητα, τιμιότητα και εξαιρετική ποιότητα και για τους πελάτες μας 15 λεπτά πάρκινγκ δωρεάν. Και μην ξεχνάτε, το United Brothers, γωνία 30 Avenue και 33ος δρόμος στην Αστόρια, ποτέ δεν είναι αργά, γιατί είμαστε πάντα ανοιχτά.
To a wonderful new salad bar here in Astoria, Create, which is healthy, vibrant, fresh food, owned by Greeks. And we're with Rosy and with Elli, and they came from Greece, from Alkithiki, and they're bringing us all this wonderful fresh food. Elli μου, γεια σου, τι κάνεις? Κύριε Rosy, χαίρο πολύ. Και μου φτιάχνει, κύριε Rosy, τους χυμούς, γιατί από εδώ τρώω συνήθως. Elli μου, πες μου λίγο για την ιδέα του μαγαζιού και πόση ωραία ανταπόκριση έχετε από τον κόσμο για όλα αυτά τα ωραία φαγητά που προσφέρετε.
Μάλιστα. Αυτό οργανώθηκε. Είπαμε να κάνουμε κάτι διαφορετικό, κάτι πιο φρέσκο. Δεν νομίζω να υπάρχει κάτι παρόμοιο στην Αστόρια. Έχουμε salad bar, νομίζω ότι είναι το καλύτερο που υπάρχει στην Αστόρια για σαλάτες. Είναι όλα φρέσκα, είναι organic.
Και φτιάχνετε, όποιος θέλει φτιάχνει τη δικιά του τη σαλάτα.
Μπορείς να κάνεις, αυτό είναι και το the whole theme που έχουμε στο μαγαζί. Create your own salad, your own juice, ό,τι θέλετε.
Και τώρα στη μόδα πολύ είναι το juicing. Κύριε Rosy, εσείς είστε εδώ κάθε μέρα, προσφέρετε ωραία λαχανικά και φρούτα στον κόσμο. Πείτε μου λίγο για τις...
Ναι. Όλα φρέσκα και καθαρά. Ο κόσμος αγαπάει τα φρέσκα, τους χυμούς τους φρέσκους, που γίνονται στη στιγμή, εκείνη τη στιγμή που το θέλει ο καθένας.
Εγώ, I'm a big juicer. Όλη μέρα I juice, I drink a lot. Πες μας λίγο για πόσο καλό είναι για την υγεία μας.
Πρώτα απ' όλα, ένα ποτήρι χυμό σε γεμίζει. Είναι σαν να έχεις φάει ένα ολόκληρο γεύμα. Οπότε, παίρνεις όλα τα απαραίτητα συστατικά, όλες τις βιταμίνες και ό,τι χρειάζεται ο οργανισμός σου. Δεύτερον, είναι πάρα πολύ υγιεινό. Έχουμε κάνει κάτι συνδυασμούς με διάφορα φρούτα και λαχανικά και το καθένα είναι για κάποιο λόγο.
Να για πούμε κάποια από αυτά, ναι.
Έχουμε το νούμερο ένα που λέγεται Energizer και είναι the most popular juice we have here. Το παίρνουν συνήθως για να ξεκινήσουν τη μέρα τους. Παίρνουν να φάνε.
Αντί για καφέ δηλαδή, ένα φυσικό χυμό, ναι, που είναι και πολύ πιο, ναι, καλό.
Λέγεται Energizer. Έχει μέσα και φρούτα και λαχανικά. Και νομίζω ότι οι συνδυασμοί που έχουμε είναι όλοι γευστικότατοι.
Mm-hmm. Για πες μου και για άλλα.
Εμένα προσωπικά αγαπημένος μου είναι το Rejuvenator.
Και εμένα, αυτό θα μας κάνει η Rosy. Ένα Rejuvenator για μένα και την Έλλη, γρήγορα! Και τι έχει το Rejuvenator?
Έχει πατζάρια, έχει ανανά, έχει αγκούρια, κέο, λεμόνι, μήλο.
Οπότε μπορούμε και εμείς από τη φύση, δώρο Θεού, όλα αυτά, να εκμεταλλευτούμε. Μας τα έχει δώσει ο Θεός για να μπορέσουμε, ό,τι πάσχουμε, να μπορέσουμε να το θεραπεύσουμε μέσα από τη φύση.
Πω και ένα άλλο. Έχω παρατηρήσει ότι οι μαμάδες που έρχονται με τα παιδιά τους και δεν τρώνε φρούτα τα παιδιά τους και δεν τρώνε λαχανικά, με αυτόν τον τρόπο, με το χυμό, μπορούν να τα ξεγελάσουν σε εισαγωγικά, ναι, ώστε να πιούν το χυμό και να πάρουν τις βιταμίνες που πρέπει.
Αυτό είναι πάρα πολύ καλό. Το πούμε στους τηλεθεατές μας. Όσοι τα παιδιά σας δεν θέλουν να τρώνε τα λαχανικά και το μπρόκολο και αυτά, θα τους γελάσουμε, να το βάλουμε μέσα, ναι, στο πλένο με την κυρία Rosy.
Να το πιούνε χυμό.
Κύριε χυμό. Ναι.
Και για το δέρμα τι προτείνουμε, Έλλη?
Λοιπόν, διβάζουμε έξτρα κάποια άλλα πράγματα. Για έξτρα ενέργεια έχουμε πρωτεΐνη και κρεατίνη. Για περισσότερο φρέσκο δέρμα, επιδερμίδα και χαμό.
Ακούστε καλά, ακούστε, ναι.
Χρησιμοποιούμε aloe vera και cayenne pepper.
Λοιπόν, cayenne pepper και aloe vera, κυρία Rosy.
Για να φανταστείς, το cayenne pepper το χρησιμοποιούν μέσα στα καλλιντικά αυτή τη σκόνη. Για τις πούδρες, για make-up, για οτιδήποτε. Οπότε,
θα το πιούμε,
πόσο
λοιπόν.
Μάλλον να το πιούμε, πόσο καλύτερο θα είναι για τον οργανισμό.
Και για καθαρισμό, κύριε Ρόζη, τι λαχανικά βάζουμε?
Σάλαρι, beet, carrot και apple.
Α, πολύ ωραία. Και τελευταίο?
Έχουμε επίσης και το healthy heart, το οποίο έχει πράσινο μήλο, ginger και πορτοκάλι.
Λοιπόν, όλοι εδώ για juicing. να γίνουμε πιο υγιέστατοι, να...
Όμορφη επιδερμίδα.
Πιο όμορφη επιδερμίδα και να πάρουμε ενέργεια. Αφήστε τους καφέδες, αφήστε τα Diet Cokes και αυτά τα πράγματα. Ελάτε στο Create να φάτε φρέσκες σαλάτες και να πιείτε λαχανικά. Και πείτε μας, κύριε Ρόζη, πόσα λαχανικά βάζετε μέσα? Δηλαδή το κάθε...
Όταν έχω ένα μεγάλο ποτήρι...
Στο σπίτι, δηλαδή, οι κυρίες που μας παρακολουθούν και οι κύριοι, πώς θα φτιάξουν το juice?
Ας πούμε πέντε είδη, έξι. Θα βάλω, ας πούμε,
το αγκουράκι, δηλαδή μισό αγκουράκι.
Το κανονίζω. Βάζω από όλα μια ποσότητα που είναι αναλογική στο ποτήρι.
Ωραία, να γίνει, ναι. Να γεμίσει το
να
ποτήρι.
Να γεμίσει το ποτήρι και να έχει από όλες τις ουσίες, από όλα.
Ωραία. Ναι. Λοιπόν, σας ευχαριστούμε πάρα πολύ. Εμείς θα πιούμε το juice αυτό, λέγεται Rejuvenate, για να το δοκιμάσουμε. Rejuvenate, guys. Awesome, hits the spot. Every day, juicing. That's what we recommend here from New Greek TV.
Κοπιάστε για καταπληκτικό φαγητό. Κοπιάστε για γνήσια κυπριακή κουζίνα. Κοπιάστε για ζωντανή μουσική κάθε Παρασκευή και Σάββατο. Κοπιάστε. Αναλαμβάνουμε και κοινωνικές εκδηλώσεις στην ανανεωμένη αίθουσά μας. Τώρα και free delivery. Κοπιάστε στο 2315 31 Street, Αστόρια, με τηλέφωνο 718 932 3220. Homeric Tours. Πάντα κοντά στην ομογένεια, πάντα με χαμηλότερες τιμές. Homeric Tours. Το γραφείο παράδοση που επί σειρά ετών φροντίζει τον Έλληνα ταξιδιώτη με υπευθυνότητα και του προσφέρει ασφάλεια και άνεση στα ταξίδια του. Homeric Tours. Το α και το ω για τα ταξίδια σας. Για πληροφορίες και κρατήσεις θέσεων, τηλεφωνήστε στο 212-753 1100.
And now we're gonna close it off with exercise. We wanna give you some tips for weight gain and for weight loss. And for weight loss, there's a lot of new techniques that are out there. We've been doing them for a very, very long time, many, 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 many years, but it's on the market now. It's called HIIT and boot camp and circuit training and interval training. We have been doing this throughout all of our personal training years to our clients.
Exercise has a physiological basis. So whether you call it fit, whether you call it boot camp, whether you call it anything, if you analyze the energy systems that provide you with the energy that you can do these exercises, you find, after all, some time to yourself in order to burn the calories that you have extra, and why not build some more muscle through the adaptations that take place through weight or exercise training in general.
Exercise physiology has given us many formulas that allow us to burn fat at a faster rate, and that's what high interval intensity training programs do, and that's what is boot camp, and that's what circuit training is. It's back to back without stopping, that allows the body to increase your metabolism even after you exercise, after your program's done. Your body is still burning. So we want you to look into those programs.
We need to be a little bit...
We need to be in shape. We need to be in good shape to do those programs. So, George,
For someone who starts an exercise program, who has been inactive for a long time and he wants to exercise, I would suggest that he does more of weight training at the beginning and then lean towards the aerobic training. Okay, and then going towards the high intensity interval training.
Because there's a program for beginners, there's a program for intermediate, and there's a program for advanced levels.
Exactly.
But we want you to at least start moving and love yourself, love your body. We want you to love yourself because it all starts the mind, the body, and the soul, the ancient Greeks, and we're going to bring that message back to you. So, Xenia, leave a message for our viewers about behavioral modification techniques.
Sure, I think it really does require you to take very small steps, identify your triggers, what triggers you to eat. I think a lot of people who are overeat tend to be in denial about how much they eat, what foods they eat. Oh, this is healthy, but if you look at the ingredients, it's very packaged, it's very processed. So there's a lot of denial as well, people, and then there's a lot of lack of knowledge of an education about different foods. So identifying your trigger points, identifying foods that trigger more eating. Sometimes we have foods that if when we eat them, we want to eat more and more, and it's hard to stop. So identifying that, and then getting out of the house, identifying night times that you're bored, times that are difficult for you emotionally. You know, if you're depressed, it might be good to talk to someone. If you're anxious all the time and constantly feel on edge, it might be good to talk to someone as well, just to kind of identify, okay, what's really happening here. Low self-esteem is a very big issue in overeating, or even not eating.
Oh, not eating. That's another topic
exactly.
That we're going to save for eating, another show.
Exactly.
But not eating is also a very big problem.
Anorexia is
a result of
absolutely
not or perceiving yourself as still being heavy and,
right.
and not eating to
right.
not loving yourself, not liking yourself.
Yeah, you have distorted cognitions of how you look. So you think you look bigger than but when you're really very thin and actually painfully thin. So
yes.
So it's about identifying what your trigger points are, what time of the days are difficult for you, what are the stresses in your life, are there relationship problems, are you struggling with a child, sometimes looking after a child can be problematic, how is your work environment, all those things you really need to look at
yes,
and how
you.
That brings about psychological stress.
Beautiful, yes, absolutely. George, leave our viewers with a exercise tip to begin an exercise program.
Well, to begin, as I said before, if you're under 45 and healthy, you can start an exercise program immediately. You go strength training, you go aerobic training, running, especially now that the weather is nice, just enjoy the scenery. As far as someone who's older, 45 and over, I would suggest to go see the physician first, get clearance, and then why not do whatever they want. Now you can do water sports, you can do anything that has to do with out on the open field, running, playing sports, basketball, volleyball, anything.
Movement.
Anything is appropriate. However, balance is everything. Water yourself, eat, don't wait that, because the water actually that we drink, we expect ourselves to get thirsty first. Now remember, when we are having the sense of thirst, we have already lost like a pound and a half or a liter and a half of water. So we need to see it in a sense of not on a need to know basis, but before we get
exactly
mm-hmm. small zips of water.
It's good for your skin too. It makes you
younger. Especially now exposed to sun, we get dehydrated. Okay,
yeah.
So have a glass of water, bottle of water, drink whatever, whenever
lots
you can.
Lots of water. Cleanse yes. and avoid all those soda drinks
yes.
and carbonated.
No sugar, yes.
It's very bad for your body. And a message to our viewers about nutrition.
Vegetables, everybody. Vegetables. But you can start small and just like I said before, you know, have a salad before every meal and do it slowly and try to incorporate more of this into your diet. We want to get you to eat more vegetables because it alkalizes you and it removes you from an acidic state. So just start small, journey of 1,000 miles begins with a single step.
Absolutely. And Irini, tell our viewers a little bit about how to achieve weight loss without going to extremes.
I think that you really can, and I really believe if you put your mind to it and you have the discipline, make a plan, decide what you're going to cut out first, and then move forward like that and be patient. It's about patience. It's not going to happen overnight. Even with me, it's 10 years later. It took 4 years, you know.
It's okay, time.
It was
time.
Very frustrating sometimes, but you know, you have to move on and just keep at it because it's a whole lifestyle change. It's not just about looking thin. It's about the way you feel. We're doing it for our health of our mind and our body, so.
Yep, and we'd like to thank you for being here with us. Thank you so much for watching this episode. We will be back to talk more about these wonderful topics. And I would like to leave you off with Pan Metron Ariston Nousi Yis En Somete Yi, which is ancient Greek for nothing in excess, and the mind, the body, and the soul are one. And we need to take care of that. Thank you. Have a great day.